from the great Johnny Adams. We are very fortunate this evening where we have Miss Judy Adams. Anyway, Judy, do me a favor. This story is one that has been written time and time again.
Absolutely.
Can you share with us, with the kind of success that Johnny has and has had in the music industry, traveling all over the world, Japan, Switzerland, Germany, selling millions of albums, what is happening with the royalties, not only for the songs that he's written, but for the music that is being sold? Share with us what's going on with him and his royalties.
Well, basically, let me start back from the beginning. Johnny Adams performed with a lot of famous singers that are on his albums, such as Aaron Neville's, Harry Connick Jr., Bonnie Raitt, and the most beloved Ruth Brown, real great friend of ours. Just numerous famous recording artists, which really puts Johnny into the stardom, starlight, and he was able to begin touring all over the country. Johnny Adams has now 28 CDs that has been released throughout his career. Unfortunately, with the horror stories of a lot of the legendary African-American musicians that have struggled to fight the record companies to access some of the royalties that rightfully belong to them, it has truly been a fight not quite won at this time. It's been a fight for me the last 9 years, almost 10 years. September would be the passing of Johnny. And I have had attorneys in the past that seem to not be able to recuperate royalties for myself. The problems I'm having with the record companies, they're just not paying. They refuse to pay the royalties. And the one record company that is paying the low royalties, the discrepancy in the sales is astronomical. They're telling me they're selling a few hundred records, and we fill up legal sound scans that's showing hundreds of thousands of Johnny Adams records that have been sold and continually selling all over the United States as well as overseas. And, I'm being told a few hundred records are being sold. And this is just heartbreaking. Knowing my husband poured his blood, sweat, and tear into all this music. And being a widow with a small child, I haven't been able to recuperate what rightfully belongs to Johnny Adams and his estate. Also, the difficulties that I'm having, and Johnny had in the past, was that the record company never allowed him to have legal representation at the signings of any of his record contracts.
That is certainly something that has existed over many, many years. Is there any organization that is working with persons such as yourselves, wives, sisters, brothers, people who should be compensated by the estate of great African-American artists who were not able to have legal representation at the time in which they were recording these songs?
Well, I hear a lot of horror stories from a lot of the musicians that grew up with Johnny in the New Orleans area. You know, back then there was a lot of racism and still a lot of racism in New Orleans. The Genesis 6 incident in Louisiana was no surprise to me. The racism is so vivid and alive. The music industry is just basically licensed to steal, now dressed in a different form. Slavery existed then for Johnny in the early 50s and 60s and continued to live now as you see through his records and the battles that a widow has trying to get these record companies to pay the royalties to the estate.
Is there any organization that you're aware of? I heard you mention that you had an individual lawyer and then maybe a series of lawyers that were working on your behalf, but just as an individual.
Well, I have had attorneys that I've obtained in the past, which I have, you know, exhausted money with no success. I did have attorneys for the last few years representing the Johnny Adams estate, which he has been not able to recuperate more than $2,000 in the last 9 years. And, you know, this attorney actually handles a lot of James Brown's, you know, business with his music also. So I don't know if it's what type of ties there, you know, there are, but I can certainly say this. It's been a battle trying to get royalties from the record companies, and since Johnny died, several CDs have been released without my knowledge. The record companies have not contacted me. The only way I found out that records were released, I've actually had to find out on the internet. The record company has totally disrespected my husband and, you know, me as a widow.
Me a favor. One of the good things that has come out of this in the last several years is the fact that you wrote the Johnny Adams story. Tell us about the book. Tell us where we can get a copy of the book. And in the background, underneath, we're listening to one of the last songs recorded by Johnny Adams. It's called This Time I'm Gone for Good. Tell us about the book.
Well, the Johnny Adams story, New Orleans Blues Legend, is the true story of his life. It's his life story. And it talks about, you know, the music industry being corrupt and basically him being enslaved and trying to break away from the slavery. Johnny actually took a trip to Detroit with some other musicians back in the late 50s. And Barry Gordy from Motown Records, the new company, was just getting started at the time. And he actually chose Johnny to come to the label, to his label. And when Johnny's record company found out about it, they threatened Motown Records, Barry Gordy. They threatened Johnny and held him in New Orleans. So Johnny should have been a superstar. So I give the credit of actually, I would say Johnny died in 98, but basically the record companies killed him back in the early 60s and 59, 60. So I wrote the book, and I'm actually the published writer. I own all rights to the book. I've designed the cover, and, you know, it just tells the story about this famous musician that just truly did not get his due. And you can purchase the book. It's on ebook, and the website is johnnyadams.org, www.johnnyadams.org. And to Johnny Adams fans, I am definitely looking for support. And my website is judy.a.adams@gmail.com. And if you're a true Johnny Adams fan, you really need to get this book. And it tells the story of this legend and everything that was pretty much done to Johnny. His civil rights was taken away from him. He was enslaved by some of the record companies and producers. He was tricked into signing contracts that he could not even read or understand. Johnny dropped out of school at the age of 15, not because he didn't want to go, but back in the early 20s and 30s, schools were 10 miles away or further, and many young African Americans dropped out of school because of the long, treacherous walk. And these record companies knew he did not have the education to read legal documentations, contracts, but he was tricked and forced into signing a lot of these contracts. And, you know, hopefully justice, you know, may be done. And that's why I'm telling the Johnny Adams story.
Let me have that website again, please.
It's www.johnnyadams.org.
And your email address?
It's judy.a.adams@gmail.com.
Thank you so much for joining us. I appreciate you. I look forward to picking up the book. I am going to get this myself. I'm going to pick up a copy of this. The New Orleans Blues Legend, the Johnny Adams story.
One other quick thing I may mention. I guess the story was just so, you know, intense and, you know, just repulsive that I had really the blessing of getting the National Action Network to actually step in and support me. And they have taken the case, so they are supporting me. And, you know, asking that everyone that's a Johnny Adams fan, you know, go to his website, you know, purchase this book, you know, help support me. Right now, I'm in need of legal representation right now because I've pretty much exhausted the funds on these attorneys that just did not come through for me.
Get the website again?
It's www.johnnyadams.org.
Thank you so much for joining us.
And thank you so much for having me.
Appreciate you. We're still hanging out in the B.B. King Blues Room.